Hi, my name is Linda Kelley. I live in Newport News, Virginia. And I recently had a hip replacement with Dr. Burrow. I discovered I had a problem in June. I thought I just had a pulled muscle, but it turned out I needed a new hip. I was not too enthusiastic about this. Matter of fact, I was rather negative about the whole idea. I asked a lot of questions about the procedure and about what the actual hip replacement looked like and what happened and what the surgery was like and what the follow-through was. I think I was probably a bit of a pest with my questions, but Dr. Burrow was very patient and very helpful, very considerate, listened to all my questions and answered them, and it was very helpful. It made me feel quite secure. We first decided to try the cortisone injection into the joint, then waited to see what would happen. Most of my pain was in my knee, so I was real worried about my knee since I had had arthroscopic surgery on that a few years back. However, it turned out, they kept telling me, the pain is not the knee, the hip is causing the knee pain, and since a lot of nerves go through that joint, you can expect some rather unusual responses. He continued to monitor this, and about the end of October, I suddenly had a distinct loss of function, meaning that suddenly, I couldn't go up the stairs one step at a time. I had to take one step, or I couldn't alternate legs. I had to take one step and then another step. And that was, I was not happy about that. And I was sort of hauling myself up. I have 15 steps and a curved staircase in my house. And secondly, I noticed that my hip would sort of give out, but I would catch it. And that was proceeding to get more negative, and getting up and down out of a chair, it seemed like it would get stuck in a very painful position, which I would breathe through, and then it would pass. So I came in to see Dr. Burrow and explained this, and he took new x-rays and said it had suddenly or progressively gotten much worse. Matter of fact, one point was almost bone on bone. And at that point, I made a decision, this was in November, to proceed with the surgery as soon as we could schedule it. We scheduled it for January at Mary Immaculate Hospital, which took excellent care of me all the way through the process from the first interview to rolling me back out to my car. I was on the cane for 1 week. Then I kind of carried it around in the car in the second week. I was cleared to drive on day 9, which I don't think is quite typical. I think one thing that really contributed to the success of my recovery and the rapidity of it was that when I discovered I needed a new hip back in June, I immediately upped my exercise schedule. I did a lot of swimming. I was swimming a mile a couple times a week and doing what I could do to do as much as you're comfortable with, because I think that really contributed to my recovery and the success of things. And of course, the expertise of Dr. Burrow, I think he was just the right doctor for me. I cannot more highly recommend this whole operation. It's excellent from top to bottom. I have vast experience here with a dad who had a hip replacement, a mother with two knees replaced and two broken necks done, and I had a knee, arthroscopic knee surgery a few years back. So whenever I get the opportunity, I have a lot of experience with these people, and they listen to you. They're very professional, and it's an excellent, we're so fortunate to have it here in Newport News.